guys, I'm Mike, and I just wanted to take a minute to talk to you guys about discipleship. And to me, discipleship takes place in two different ways. The first is invitation, and the second is investing in people. And to look at this, we're going to look at the relationship between Paul and Timothy. And when we first meet Timothy, it's in Acts chapter 16, where Paul travels to Lystra. And in Lystra, he hears so many great things about Timothy and his potential in leadership. And so Paul simply just goes up and invites him to come along with Paul on his missionary journey. And it's just as easy as that, guys. And because of that, I would like to challenge you guys to just start inviting people. That doesn't mean they're going to have to come. It doesn't mean anything. But invitation is just the first step. And I'm going to give you one quick and easy way that we could invite people to come alongside Town South with you. And that's the Move Retreat coming up later this summer. The Move Retreat is going to be pretty awesome. Corbin and I and Eamon and Zach are putting in a lot of work. And an easy way for you guys to start discipling other people is simply to invite them and say, hey, my youth group is putting on this cool event, and I would like for you to come alongside me and experience this. No major commitment, just inviting. The second one is investing. And this is when things become a little more serious. For Paul and Timothy, Paul spent years of his life just pouring into Timothy. For instance, we can look in the Bible and see there are books that of the Bible that Paul have written specifically for Timothy so that Timothy could be poured into even though Paul was away. And that's the type of relationship that we want to develop when we're talking about discipleship. Investing in people is huge in terms of discipleship. And I think it's super important because that's where the biggest growth happens. And I can talk about Paul and Timothy all day, but I think it's more important for you to hear this from a personal perspective. Now, if you've watched the Peter podcast, you'll have already heard my personal story of how I became a youth minister and where I am today. If you haven't watched it, I suggest you go do that. It's a really great video. I really enjoyed making it with Corbin. But right now, we're going to switch over to Corbin, and he's going to explain how discipleship and invitation and investing has personally impacted his life.
So, Mike is talking about this idea of discipleship, and his two ideas are inviting and investing. And so I can't help but think about those two things as well when I think about my story and how I got to being a youth minister here at Town South. When I was in high school, well, 8th or 9th grade, my youth minister courageously walked into my front yard one day and invited me to go play Ultimate Frisbee down the road at the park. And if it wasn't for him being courageous and bold enough to do that out of the blue one day, it would have never had left to me giving my life to the Lord. And so I'm forever grateful for that invitation into his life that then led to him investing in me. And now there's a lot of other people along the way that have taken time to invite me into their life and to also invest in me. But the initial step for Jesus to work in my life and to help me make a decision to follow him and to become a youth minister and to care about discipleship was because of one person inviting me to enter their life. And so as Mike has said in this video, take the opportunity to think about who you can invite into your life so you can invest in them and show who Jesus is.